guys, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with a brand new book tag, but this time I decided to add a little bit of spice and a little bit of masala in it. As you would have seen from my channel, there are 3 or 4 videos that revolve around traveling. I absolutely love traveling, going to new places, seeing new cultures, experiencing new atmospheres, talking to new people. Though talking to new people might seem a little too outlandish for an introvert like me. So my dreams of traveling might not come true just yet. Traveling extensively is what I mean. So what I did was I combined 2 things that I love the most, books and traveling. And I came up with a book travel tag. So I looked for ideas on how to go about creating this tag. I even went to Google and I turned to YouTube. But while YouTube gave me results only based on the book tags, there was nothing related to travel in those. Google was a different matter altogether. It started giving me ideas for luggage tags. Though I don't mind that, that is really not what I was looking for. I'm not sure if anybody has done this tag before, but these 8 questions are something that I came up with. I just hope that this tag is quite enjoyable for you to watch. And if you're interested, please go ahead. I'll tag a few booktubers at the end of the video. So before that, let's get started with this tag. The first question is, which is your most favorite travel book ever? By travel book, I mean any book based on travel. It may be fiction, it may be non-fiction, anything. To tell you the truth, I haven't read much of travel related books, but the book that I remember falling in love with and completely being entranced by it is Eat, Pray, Love. Eat, Pray, Love taught me a lot. Actually, it taught me about being independent. It taught me that it's okay to be sad. It taught me that it's okay to indulge yourself if you want to actually overcome something that's happened in your life. And most importantly, it taught me that traveling, books and pizza, this is the best combination ever. The second question is, which was the last book that made you feel like you wanted to travel to the place in which it was set? Of late, I've been reading a lot of books that have been really good and that have been successful in evoking emotions in me that I wouldn't have thought possible. But the last book, as the question obviously says, that actually made me want to travel there and interact with the residents and take part in the discussions that are going on there was the Guernsey Literary and Potato Peel Pie Society. Written by Mary Ann Schaffers and Annie Barrows, this book gives such a beautiful description of Guernsey that I couldn't help but thinking in my mind, oh, it would be so nice to go and meet these people. Of course, that's not possible because those people don't exist, but the place exists. So let's hope that someday I can go there and experience whatever Mary Ann Schaffer and Annie Barrows have explained in their book. I actually did a video review of the Guernsey Literary and Potato Peel Pie Society a couple of weeks ago. You can check it out here. The third question is, which book would you carry if you were traveling to the mountains, to a beach town and to a city? To the mountains, I would probably carry a stack of Ruskin Bond's books because he lives in the mountains. His writing is set in the mountains mostly. And it's so beautiful that you want to live his stories with them. So finally, when I am actually climbing a mountain, then I think reading Ruskin Bond's books gives it all the more the sense of justice. Coming to what I would carry to a beach town, I would probably carry a Cecilia Ahern book because her books are easy to read, but yet they carry such heaviness, such meaning that it becomes difficult to detach from the words that are coming right back at you. It's just like the sand and the water. Like, they look like they're coming together and drifting apart, but they're not really apart. So that's why I think a Cecilia Ahern book would make for great company in a beach town. And to a city, I would carry any Jeffrey Archer book. The reason why I'd carry a Jeffrey Archer book to a city is because in a metropolis, what is most required is peace. Because of all the hullabaloo and the chaos that's going on around you, you just need something that flows easily. It gives you a sense of peace and calm while giving you an adrenaline rush. So I think Jeffrey Archer is the perfect combination of all of those. So if you find me traveling to a city, then I think Jeffrey Archer would be the perfect companion. The fourth question is, which fantasy place would you love to travel to? There's absolutely no question about it. The answer, without a doubt, is Hogwarts. But there's also Hogsmeade, and then there's Grimmauld Place, and then there's Platform 9¾, and the Ministry of Magic. There are so many places. Diagon Alley. How could I forget even one of these? To be fair to every magical place in the world, I'd only say I'd love to visit the Harry Potter universe. I know it's not exactly a specific place, but if the universe can be called a place to live in, then the Harry Potter universe should be called a place that one can visit. The fifth question is related to the fourth one. It is called, which fantasy place would you never travel to ever? There are two places that are vying for the top spot here. One is King's Landing and the other is Panem. I have just started reading Game of Thrones and I am about halfway through it. But I've watched the series so far and I really don't want to give out any spoilers, but King's Landing is not the place to be, ever. Unless you're a Lannister, please go far, far away from that place and live in peace. King's Landing is never going to give you any happiness, any joy. You can be killed at any moment. And then there's Panem, which has the Hunger Games. I know it's over and all, but I still wouldn't want to go and live in a place with such memories. I agree that after the first book, things went downhill. But the concept was great if you think of a dystopian fantasy world. The sixth question is, which travel character do you think would make a great travel companion for you? For me, I think it's going to be Hermione Granger, because have you seen the way she organizes her stuff? She is smart, she knows where to go, what to do, what precautions to take, and what to do next. She knows everything. So yeah, I'm keeping her by my side if I'm going anywhere. But in addition to Hermione Granger, I love her and all, but she's a little on the serious side. So while traveling, I want some fun with me. So I'd most probably take Fred and George along, and probably Ron, because he would be jealous because his brother went along with his girlfriend or something. So yeah, it would be Hermione Granger, Fred and George Weasley, and Ron Weasley. The seventh question is, which collection of short stories would you take along if you went city hopping? Okay, so don't judge me, but there are a couple of authors who figure heavily on all my lists, and this list is one such. But the short story collections that I'd love to take on such a city hopping journey would be The Tales of Beedle the Bard by J.K. Rowling, any short story collection by Jeffrey Archer, and Agatha Christie short story collections, and also 100 Selected Short Stories by O. Henry. So the last question is, which is the best city, town, or village that you've ever visited, and which book reminds you of this place? In my limited travels so far, I think the best city that I've visited is New York. I'm not just saying it because it's the Big Apple and I fulfilled a dream of setting foot in such a huge city and all that, but New York is truly a city that everyone must visit once in their lifetime. But the best place that I visited in New York is Central Park. The air there is so pure, with people playing, being carefree, leaning back against trees and sitting and just enjoying their day and not rushing away anywhere. There are people exercising, there are people playing, they're doing their own thing, but they're not in a rush. And that makes New York City a little bit of a paradox. Yet, this place, New York City, Central Park in particular, remains my absolute favorite. And the book that reminds me of New York City the most is Love Story. It is set in the 1970s, but the description of how Jenny and Oliver fell in love while traversing through the city warmed my heart like anything. It's a small love story, it's a very short book, but I fell in love with it the way you fall asleep, slowly and then all at once. Called enough stars. So those were the questions for the book travel tag, and I hope you liked this video. I tagged Meera Nair, Heli from the Heli blog, and Ashima from the Book Den to do this tag. I'll list out the questions in the description below so that it will be easier for you to keep track of them. If you like this video, please hit like and share to spread the word. And if you like my content and would like to see more from me, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notified as and when I upload. Thanks for watching. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add melodrama to your life.